Magandang hapon po sa inyong lahat. Welcome to the last episode of Trading My Sorrows, How Persecuted Christians Are Facing COVID-19. Magandang hapon po sa inyong lahat na nanonood ngayon, sumusubaybay sa ating last episode today. Now, we've been doing this for 1 week. Nagsimula po tayo nung Monday. At ngayon is our last day. Now, I feel like it's a reason to celebrate, no? I feel celebratory, kung tama man yung English na yan, no? But I just feel that we have, not only that we have survived the week 3 ng ating ECQ, but we have come to the last episode of our live session. Salamat po muli sa lahat na sumusubaybay. Ngayon po kayong na mga nanonood at simula po ng Lunes, kayo pong lahat na nakisama sa amin at natutunan natin kung nalaman natin kung ano ang nararanasan ng ating mga kapatid sa Panginoon na pinag-uusig sa kanilang pananampalataya at doon sa mga bansa where they are. And even in the midst of COVID, ay ano yung kanilang mga unique experiences and also shared experiences with us dito sa Pilipinas, no? Maraming similarities, like they were also hampered in their ministries, in their church life. Marami din po sa kanila ang nawala ng trabaho dahil sa they are day job earners. At pareho din ang mga churches ay nag-live stream, katulad po natin dito. At and then they also continue to be the salt and light, lalo po sa panahon ngayon, as a testimony to their countries, no? And especially sila ay persecuted doon, they are a minority. At sabi ng isang report din sa atin that I've shared with you this week, sabi hindi naman tumigil ang persecution, even though there is a pandemic ongoing, no? Kaya salamat, because we have learned so many things. Ako, even while reading the reports, ay na-encourage po ako, no? Even though I know already a few things about these countries, I am still amazed by the courage of the persecuted church, even in the midst of this pandemic. No, all the more in the midst of this pandemic. Okay. Hello po sa mga sumama na sa atin as early as this. Sorry, we came in late for some technical problems. Sabi ko, parang may last day na, nag-technical problems pa tayo. Kaya wala po akong nalagay dyan na post that we are already live. Pagkatapos, wala tayong poll. Wala akong na-type talaga kasi nagloloko siya. And we have also tried another application sana to make this Friday even more special with better quality. Pero kaya na-late po tayo ng mga 4 minutes sa 3 p.m. broadcast. Pero thank you so much dahil gumana pa rin siya and you are here, no? So, una-una nakita ko nag-join dito. Hello kay Mark at kay Anne, mga churchmates ko yan, sa KKSJ. Hello, thank you for joining. You are also here yesterday. Now, salamat. Si Daddy Lito from Italy, sabi niya, magandang hapon, new day, new blessing. Amen. Hope you are as normal, as strong as before, no? And as pogi din. Si Mami, ayan, nandiyan na. Salamat, Mami, for hosting watch parties for the live. Hindi lang dahil anak niya ako, no? Pero she's, in doing that, she's helping more and more people get to know about the persecuted church. Marami ako nakita sa mga comment section niya na mga nanakanood, nag-comment na wala dito sa actual live. Pero dun sa watch party na nanonood kay Mami, and they share their reflections there. So, salamat. Kung gusto nyong tulungan din kami na lalo pang marami ang makarinig, makapakinig nito ang about Open Doors and about persecuted Christians. You can also do the same, actually. So thanks, Mami. Host a watch party so that your circle, your network, can get to know also about persecuted Christians. Pastor Clyde from Butuan City, down south in Mindanao. Hello, welcome back. Ma'am Flora, isa sa mga top fans natin, nakalagay na dyan, recognition ng Facebook. Thank you for being here every day. A pleasant good day, sabi niya, God's blessings be upon us always. Thank you so much. And thank you so much, Ma'am Flora, for tuning in daily. Ma'am Cecil Bayawa is here once again from Baguio City, sa Irisan. Regards again kay Pastor Lino and to the family. No, they run a school, ang kanilang ministry, and also a church. They lead the church, at ang kanilang school at ang kanilang church ay very faithful prayer partners and the financial supporters of the ministry. Kaya salamat po sa inyo, and the Lord continue to bless you and the ministries po. My auntie is there, Tita Gigi, hello. And then si Aaron. Hi, Aaron. Aaron comes from Berean Gospel Church of QC. No, marami tayong mga taga-Berean dito who has been watching us. Okay. Kahapon, I realized na hindi pala tayo nag-end well dahil naputol ako sa inyong sa broadcast. No, humina na yung aking internet signal. So my apologies for that, but you only missed the last parts of the Syrian pastor's prayer that I read as we closed in prayer. Okay lamang po yun. Hindi ko lang na-promote yung kumanta po sa atin yesterday, si Kevin Candole, who is actually my younger brother. So salamat, maraming salamat, Kevin, for giving us your, sharing with us your talent, your time. Napaka busy pong tao niyan, to the point na minsan wala siyang tulog dahil sa kanyang work. But thank you so much for sharing with us the message of the song, very timely, Carrie Jo B's Healer. No, thank you so much. Libre yan. So thank you, Kevin. Ma'am Anna from Baguio City as well, thank you so much. You've been also watching us since Monday. Sabi niya, our God is in control even in this health crisis. Yes, He is. Every time, no? Kahit na minsan we feel He's not in control, we feel that the world is spinning out of control, but no, He always looks down, He always sees the big picture. And yes, that's very true, Ma'am Anna. Thank you so much for that statement. Frank Cruz, sabi niya, Shalom from Angeles City. Hello, Brother Frank. Thank you so much for watching today. And I'm seeing your name engaging sa mga posts na Open Doors PH. Thank you so much. No, alam niyo po yung mga engagement na ginagawa niyo sa Open Doors, liking, sharing, commenting, and watching our live episodes, ay lahat po yan ay suporta ninyo sa amin sa gawain ng Open Doors PH at sa Persecuted Church, because I'm sure as you engage yourself more sa mga karanasan, sa mga reflections, and even the lessons that persecuted Christians are experiencing, ay nakakapagpalakas po ng pananampalataya natin, no? And tulad nung shinare ko na reflection ng isang frontliner doctor that we na nakakasama natin dito sa ating live episode, ay sabi niya it helped her refocus her attention, no, sa lahat na nangyayaring negativity, uncertainty, but just hearing the courage, hearing inspiration stories of the persecuted church ay nakatulong sa kanya to just pause, no, sa lahat ng nangyayaring ito, no, and she was able to pause and be refreshed, no. The Lord used those courageous testimonies of faith ng ating mga persecuted brothers and sisters to minister to her, no. So kaya salamat for that reflection, and for every one of you who share that reflection as well. Okay, so andyan na yung ating singer kahapon, si Kevin, hello, thank you for tuning in. Si Marvin, hi Direk, he comes from Malolos, Bulacan, all the way from Malolos. Hello sa inyo ni Pam at ang aking inaanak. Kuya Jun Holoan, thank you once again for joining us today. You were with us yesterday, no? God bless, sabi niya, God bless you too. Si Ma'am Jeanette Gubuan, hello po. Thank you so much for tuning in today. Regards po kay Sir Oh no, I forgot the name of sir. Sorry po, pero thank you so much. Forgive me. But thank you so much for watching. Sila po ay mga campus missionaries. No? Very faithful prayer partners and financial supporters of Persecuted Christians. Ma'am Glenda Run or Rune, no? Sabi niya, God got this. Yes, God got this. Yes. Amen. That's very true. Ate Marov Esguera from Guiding Light Christian Church of Baguio. Hello po. Sabi niya, blessed afternoon, Brother BJ, Open Doors Brethren, and to everyone watching. Thank you so much. Si Lola Edna Garantuza also joined. Hello po, Lola Edna. Hope that si Tito, Tita Gay and Kuya Sunny are back safe from the hospital. No? Okay, si Ma'am Edna Balispis also from Baguio. There is never a time so dark in which we cannot thank God. Wow. Sabi niya, thanking God for Brother BJ and the Ministry of Open Doors. Marami pong salamat. Sabi niya again, there is never a time so dark in which we cannot thank God. Thank you. Thank you for that statement. And then Ma'am Glenda Run, no? Sorry if I mispronounce your last name po, but sabi niya, she tuned in from La Union. Hello po sa inyo, and thank you for representing La Union dito po sa ating live special. Okay, yesterday sabi ko rin po na I will, because dahil hindi ko na share yung mga tips ng ating ng counselor from Open Doors about how to emotionally respond in a healthy way and also spiritually speaking sa nangyayari pong ito in the isolation, in depression, in depressing situations like this, no. Sabi ko, because I wasn't able to share yesterday, I will share it now, but I realized for you to be able to find it easier, ipopost ko na lang po ito sa in one of our sa Facebook po natin, para mas mabalikan niyo po ito at mas mahanap niyo po siya. Very helpful, very practical, and actually very refreshing din siya. So I will just post it maybe next week. Yeah, next week po yan, during the Holy Week, para mas makatulong po sa atin how we can cope up practically coming from a professional counselor on situations like we have now. Okay, si Ate Cherry Holoan, hello po. Watching with Kuya Jun, I believe. But on different accounts, ha? Ate Nora Evangelista, hello po Ate Nors, also from Baguio City. Si Chris, hi Chris. Schoolmate ko yan sa high school in the US. Can you comment, Chris, what state you are from now? I just forgot, but hello. She is married to a Vietnamese. Yeah, who has also a very good testimony. Ate Shara Tan joined as well. Hello po, Ate Shara. Siya yung ate siya ni Aaron who was joining out. Pastor Ruel Diga, hello po. Pastor Ruel, maybe you are seeing his name in our posts sa Instagram, sa YouTube, here on Facebook. No, we did a Facebook Live nung January with him. He comes from a church called Hillcrest Church in Teachers Village, Diliman, Quezon City. And nung nilaunch po natin yung 2020 World Watch List, ay kasama ko po siyang nag-Facebook Live. So hello po, Pastor Rowell. Thank you for tuning in. Every day din po siya nag-Facebook Live, kaya sanay na sanay yan. No, hello po, Pastor Rowell. Si Tito Mar. Hello po, Tito Mar. Thank you once again for joining. And the numbers are up. And very thank you so much. Kasi as early as this, the numbers are this up. No, thank you so much. Thank you for all of you who are spreading the word about this. No, at humabol sa last day na ganito kadami ang nanonood sa atin. Okay, so thank you. Hazel, hello Hazel. Thank you for joining. We have yet to go to your store in Cavite, pero dahil quarantine, close muna siya. Pero papromote natin yan. No? Hi Hazel. And Ate Mai, coming also from the US. Okay, in our promotional post this morning, ay sabi ko po ay meron po tayong makakasama na Open Doors worker from South Africa. And we will, and sabi ko po doon, no, praying that technology permits. No, kanina we were trying the program sana na magagamitin po natin for the interview, pero hindi na naman siya, well, gumana siya for a time, pero nagkaroon na naman ng technical glitch. So, we will still have her, pero medyo magmamano-mano po muna tayo ngayon, no? I'll call her in a separate equipment, and then I will let you see her face, you will hear her, and you will get to interview her on how in that country and how they are affected and kamusta siya sa how they are dealing with COVID and others more. So, habang hindi natin siya tinatawagan, if you have a question for our open doors worker from South Africa, since we will be talking about Africa, ay pwede kayong i-comment niyo po dyan ang inyong tanong. Now, if you have a question for our worker from South Africa, since we will be talking about Africa for today. Okay? So, andyan din na si Ma'am Bing Torcolas. Sabi niya, good PM, sir. Watching from Taipei, Taiwan. Thanks all the beautiful message. Wow, hello po. All the way from Taiwan. Continue to keep safe po dyan, Ma'am Bing. Si Kuya Tabs de Jesus, hello po. Also from Guiding Light Christian Church sa Baguio. Okay, aking Lola is also there. Another Lola is also there. Hello po, Ate Alola Faye and Ate Hazel Evangelista. No, thank you so much for tuning in. Okay, so sa atin pong, before I share about Africa, we also received just today updates from some of the countries that we spoke with, no? Nitong mga nakaraang araw. At nakakatuwa po kasi we were just talking about these countries this week, pero hindi na alam, habang nag-uusap pala tayo ay marami na rin nangyayari, no, sa kani-kanilang mga konteksto at bansa. And today I was so happy just reading them. And sabi ko it's very timely for me to share these updates with you, dahil kasama niyo po ako na magkakasama po tayo in knowing about these countries and about these things. Okay, so i-share ko yan po yan saglit bago po ako mag-share about what is happening in Africa. Okay, and also na-realize ko po, no, nung una ko pong iniisip po na gawin po itong Facebook Live is just, we will just do it for 30 minutes every day. Pero on our first live episode nung Monday, ay lumagpas na po tayo agad ng isang oras, no? Because of so many things to share. At lalo po nakaka-engganyo na mag-reflect sa mga nangyayari sa persecuted Christians, no? We can share, we can relate what they are experiencing, and we are learning so much from them, no? Kaya ayun po, and kaya every day 1 hour po na yung nagsasama-sama, pero maraming salamat dahil kayo ay sinasamahan niyo po ako. You are being very patient, and thank you for your encouraging feedback as well para sa dito sa ginagawa nating Trading My Sorrows. Okay, so once again, before we call later in a while yung aking worker from South Africa, open doors worker from South Africa, I type in your questions if you have, okay, para matatanong natin sa kanya live. Okay, ito po yung mga news, mga updates that I was able to get and gather patungkol po sa ilan sa mga bansa na napag-usapan natin for this week. Okay? Unahin po natin ang bansa pong Iran. Okay? If you remember, we spoke about Middle East nung Wednesday. And sorry for that notification. And nag-release po, just to refresh you, nag-release ang gobyerno ng Iran ng around 85,000 prisoners, no? At ilan doon, kahit konti lang, ay meron pong mga nakasama sa ng mga Christian prisoners, no? Yung mga kapatid po natin na kulong because of the faith, no? Pero nabanggit ko rin po doon sa update that even though they were released, these prisoners were just temporarily released, no, hindi talaga permanent. So just for the prison cells to practice social distancing kasi masyado na silang crowded, no? But just today, we received, today our time, we received a news report, a good news, that one of them, one of the Christian sisters actually, na i-report natin, na banggit natin ang pangalan, na temporarily released alongside the 85,000 prisoners in Iran, ang hindi na po babalik sa kulungan. Kaya para po sa inyo na mga nanalangin, especially after that Middle East episode, especially about Iran, this is an answer to our prayers, no? Kasi ito pong mga prisoners who were temporarily released will be waiting for further notice hanggang sila ay babalik doon, no? O kaya they will hear trial, and if they are convicted, ay patuloy, ay kukulong muli sila unless na payagan silang mag-bail. But this sister of ours, sabi niya, we just heard from the government, the authorities, that she is now permanently released from prison. No? Salamat sa Panginoon. Thank you, Lord, for allowing this sister of ours, ang pangalan niya si Marok. Okay, and she was arrested late 2018, bago daw magpasko, nung ni-raid ng Iranian intelligence ang kanyang bahay. And she was detained at first for 10 days, and sabi din dito, she endured intense interrogation, no? At nakapag-bail siya, pero ang isang prayer request niya is itong nabayad niyang bail ay sana makuha na niya. Kasi even though may bail man ang wala, she was officially released by the Iranian government, no, by the prison authorities. Kaya ipag-pray na po natin sa kanya yon. Let's of course thank the Lord first that she's now released from prison. Thank you, Lord. Almost 2 years din, no? Kulang-kulang, no? Na 2 years. More than a year that she was in prison for the faith. And now, thank you, Lord, dahil siya ay naka-release na. So let's pray for her na mag-heal. Of course, merong traumatic experience po dito. At pagkatapos, sana they will try to get back the money na ibinayad nila for bail. So sana smooth ang maging proseso at talagang i-release sa kanya. Let's also continue to pray for those naiwan sa prison cells, especially Christians. And also those who were, yes, released, pero waiting for trial, no? Ipanalangin pa rin po natin sila. And let's also pray for the Iranian authorities for wisdom in dealing with the cases, with the increasing cases, kasi as I have we have mentioned nung Wednesday, is Iran is the epicenter of the epidemic in the Middle East, no? Napakaraming mga kaso in this country, no? The biggest in the Middle East, okay? Now, some more updates in some of the countries that we were talking about this week, no? For Southern Philippines, yung ating pong work sa Mindanao, we just got a word that we are now in touch with 30 families down south, especially coming from the Muslim background, no? So yun po yung priority ng ating gawain down south to... Dahil sila yung persecuted, sila po yung ating pinapalakas at tinutulungan. So now we are in contact with 30 families down south. So please pray as our team there plans and coordinates with the right departments, government agencies, at ilang pang mga local officials para maisagawa ang pagtulong po sa mga 30 families in down south in Mindanao. Meron din pong isang pang good news from Malaysia. Meron daw isang Christian woman na nakausap na isa sa ating mga team members for this country. Sabi niya, my husband and I have lost our income and we were praying to the Lord for a solution for our little family. We have a 1-year-old girl to take care of. Immediately after saying amen, you called us, itong ating pong gawain, to ask if we needed any basic necessities. Sabi niya, yes, we do. Thank you so much. So sila ay nabahagi na natin ng tulong. Also, good news from China, kung saan po nanggaling ang COVID. Sabi dito ng isang team member po natin working for this nation, sabi niya, restrictions are slowly lifted. At sabi niya, some of our workers have resumed work in the area where they live. They begin by visiting believers, especially daw yung mga believers from Muslim background, no? Yung mga converts from Islam, no? Yun ang kanilang unang mga binibisita. Bakit? Kasi sila po yung mga very much isolated already in recent months. Dahil tinakwil sila ng kanilang mga pamilya, so before, even before pandemic came, they were already living in isolation. So all the more when the quarantine or the lockdown was implemented in their own in their country, kaya all the more that they were literally and feeling isolated, no? So they were the ones that were visited first by our team there, no? And also our partners. Okay, in Asia, in one country in Asia na hindi po namin pwedeng sabihin ang name dahil napakadelikado po nito, ay handa na daw po yung 100 relief packs that we will be distributing in this country. And ang primary beneficiaries po nito ay mga pastors and partners who are being sidelined and ignored. No, in these countries, dahil nga ang mga persecuted Christians ay disadvantaged and discriminated. And one form of that, in situations like this, hindi sila yung prioriting bigyan ng tulong ng kanilang mga gobyerno, the national government and even the local officials. Kaya they are left out sa mga relief most of the time. At tulad po ngayon na nangyayari sa COVID-19 epidemic. Kaya yun po yung tutulungan ng ating team members in this particular country in Asia, ay mga pastors and partners and workers po natin doon. So sabi niya, each relief pack contains enough food and soap to get families through at least 2 months. At least 2 months, no? Salamat for those who have been praying for us. Ito nakakatulong po. Patuloy po tayo nakakatulong in many countries, like this country in Asia. And sabi niya, after this 100 relief packs are distributed, ay gagawa po sila ng maraming ganito. Pero very, medyo double jeopardy na naman po sila, kasi whenever they do these things, hindi lang na ang risk nila is kanilang health, but also they also risk the great risk, sabi niya dito, a great risk of being imprisoned by the authorities. Kasi not just for the faith, but this particular country, sabi niya, they do not want the world to know what is really happening in their country. Hindi niya binention kung anong bansa for their security, but I have one country in mind, pero hindi niya binanggit. So, but let's leave that kung ano man yung specifics na yon. But the situation is very real, no? Yung risk of being contaminated and also risk of being imprisoned just for helping these believers, no? And yung communities daw na kanilang pupuntahan is some of the remote communities na neglected. Alam niyo kung bakit daw? Just because they were Christians. They are Christians. Just because they are a Christian community, ay hindi na sila binibigyan or priority mabigyan ng mga tulong. Kaya yun po ang pupuntahan ng ating mga kapatid, ating team in this particular Asian country. Okay? And then, sabi pa ni Hana ay plano din nilang magsagawa kahit from a distance doon sa mga communities ng mabilis na presentation on how these families in these communities ay makakapag-practice ng mga safety measures para maiwasan ang pagkalat ng epidemic even amongst themselves in their community. Okay? Ito po, okay, I should stop talking about these updates. But thank the Lord for these updates. Marami pa akong nakuha na updates and news, but I will just post them sa Facebook, no, in relation to how the persecuted church is experiencing. And I'm sure COVID-19, and I'm sure that In the coming days ay patuloy pa ang news and updates and even testimonies ng ating mga kapatid sa Panginoon experiencing COVID, kaya I will just be posting them sa ating Facebook and maybe even sa Instagram kung ano ang nangyayari sa kanila. Okay, now I will try to now call our Open Doors worker from South Africa. Okay, wala kayong pinost na question, pero okay lang po yan. We can just converse with her naturally. But that of course we want to know what is happening with her. Of course, personally muna sa kanyang pamilya, where she is at in South Africa, how the country is coping, is facing, and then kamusta ang gawain ng Open Doors doon? At kamusta rin ang mga churches doon? How are they also reaching out to fellow believers and even to their fellow citizens? Okay, ang pangalan po niya ay si Natasha. At medyo mabilis po siya magsalita at medyo slang ang kanyang English dahil ganun sila sa South Africa. Pero let's see. So please listen carefully kapag kausap na po natin siya. Para maintindihan po natin siya. Okay, I'll just be trying to call her. And it's now dialing. Okay? It's 6 hours. We are 6 hours in advance. Kaya mga 9:30 pa lang sa kanila, sa kanilang bansa ngayon. Okay? So, ayusin ko lang yung aking camera para makita niyo po siya at makita po niya kayo. Okay. Okay. Sige. Natasha, hello. I am already live with our viewers here in the Philippines, and I've mentioned a bit of introduction for you. So, I'll let you introduce yourself before we ask you questions. Okay, so here she is. Hello.
Thank you.
Okay.
Hello, everyone.
Yeah.
It's a great privilege to be able to share with you this morning all the way from South Africa. And I'm very encouraged by your support and your prayers also for the persecuted church during this time. So thank you for this opportunity.
Okay. So mag-comment po kayo kung hindi po, kung mahina po siya, no? But I hope she is loud enough for you to hear. Okay. So first, Natasha, our question is, how are you and your family coping up with this pandemic in your country?
BJ, thank you very much for asking. We are doing very well. We are all healthy. We are all doing well. We are very grateful for that. I actually live in Cape Town, and when we found out about the national lockdown that happened last week, I decided to drive up from Cape Town to Pretoria, which is my city where I grew up and where my mom is and my brother is. So I'm in lockdown with my mom and my dog, but we are doing very well. Thank you.
Okay. How about our ministry there in Open Doors? Can you say also what you do for Open Doors and how is it now being affected by the lockdown or quarantine there in your country?
Yes. Thank you, BJ. Yes, at the moment, I'm the regional manager for the Western Cape province. It's the most powerful province in South Africa. And my responsibility is to visit churches and groups and schools to raise awareness about the persecuted church. I also have a heart and passion for children and young people, and to also share with them on their level what young people and children face every day. So for Open Doors in South Africa, all our teams are able to continue with our work, but we all do it from home now. So we are grateful for technology. There's quite a lot of challenges, as we are all aware of, that we are not allowed to visit any churches, any schools, any home cell groups, nothing at the moment. And this will definitely have a very devastating effect on raising new support for the persecuted church. So we would really appreciate, as all the other bases worldwide, for this time as well.
Yeah. How about the country of South Africa? How has it? What are the safety measures maybe that they have implemented already for the safety of the citizens?
Yes, our president, President Ramaphosa, had I think 2 or 3 national announcements that he made in the past 2 weeks about the lockdown. There's a lot of very strict guidelines for us to follow through with. There's a lot of people that that still don't follow the rules. We still hear cars driving up and down, but we are allowed to go to the shops. We are allowed to go to places if you need medicine, the bare necessities, as they say. So everything is quiet down. I think everybody's challenged because it's a 3-week, 21-day challenge, and we've only been into this for 7 days now.
For 7 days. So
it's very new for us as well to get used to.
Mm-hmm. Oh, okay. You've just been there 7 days, and we're already in our 3rd week.
Wow. So we still have a while to go.
Yeah, and hope that you will have, the Lord will bless you with creative ways to minister to the South African church in the midst of the pandemic. Do you have any news from fellow African countries about how they are facing the pandemic? Maybe you have friends from other African countries as well?
I actually went to the shop 2 days ago to buy some groceries, and I stood in line for about an hour, and there were two young guys from Zimbabwe that stood in front of me at the line. And then I asked them, so how are you coping during this time? And they said that they are very worried and they need to go back home, but they can't afford it to go back home. I think that is quite a challenge for a lot of people. We know that South Africa is also known as the Rainbow Nation, with so many people from all over the world that came to our country. But at the moment, nobody's allowed to come in or leave the country. So I think it's quite a challenge for them. And I grew up in Zimbabwe for a part of my life, so I've got a heart for the Zimbabwean people. I did ask, for our work, just ask a few questions. And we know that there's quite a huge impact on travel that makes it very difficult. And we know that there will always be persecution happening in Africa. It will continue, but so will our work. And I think emergency relief will continue during this time as well. While I was preparing, I just had a quick look to see what is happening in Africa at the moment.
Yes.
And then, I mean, the total confirmed COVID cases for the coronavirus in Africa stands at around 6,600. And if you take the World Watch list, I mean, how many of those countries, 4 countries are in the top 10 countries? And then the other countries that really stand out on our continent is countries like, Egypt, it's quite a high number. Nigeria, Algeria is also very high. Morocco, Tunisia, Cameroon, Burkina Faso. But of course, South Africa is the country that stands out the most at this stage. So we have, I think, cases about 1,600. But only, unfortunately, only 5 people has died already. But so it is a challenge to know what's happening on our continent. And this is where we live.
Does news say in your country why your country has the most cases in the continent?
I'm not exactly sure, but I think because, I mean, there's still a group of tourists, I think, from Germany that they say that are stuck in the country. So there's been a limit on tourists in the past few weeks as well coming into the country. So it's a very challenging time. But I think everybody must just play their role in washing their hands and keeping the guidelines and the safe distances. But I think it's a worldwide engagement that needs to happen.
Okay. Lastly, what we'd like to ask you, Natasha, is how can we pray for you, for our work there, and your country, and for the continent of Africa?
Yes. Thank you, Peja. I think for the Ministry of Open Doors in South Africa, I mean, we do our presentations, and that's how we get new partners, new name acquisitions, first-time donors, and we do this through face-to-face presentations. That's how we generate our support. And we had set out to host at least 1,200 presentations in the year of 2020. And if we lose a whole month of lockdown, we lose out on about 120 presentations.
Wow, oh no.
So for the work of Open Doors, that's a huge challenge.
Yeah.
But we trust God, and we are busy with a campaign for the past year to say that although persecuted, we are never alone, and that we can trust God for this season as well.
Yes.
And we know that God is faithful. But one of my colleagues, he's got a project that is called Bible Givers, where he's challenging athletes and people that really are into moving around to do exercises around their home, to run around for 4 minutes, 20 minutes, and during that time to pray for the persecutors. So he has information to share and pray for a specific country. So you can follow up on that. And we also compiled a video that's available on YouTube. If you can share that perhaps with the viewers,
sure,
just to support and pray for the persecuted church, also for the church in China and what they faced in the past few months, and that we will continue to pray, and through our prayers God will move, because he is faithful. I think we just have to trust God and stand firm and strong during this time.
Okay, thank you so much, Natasha, for joining us today. It's just morning there, having your coffee maybe, but thank you for your time to join us.
Your support, your prayers in the Philippines, we saw your country on the news last night, but you also face challenges, but may God grant you grace during this time as well.
Okay, thank you so much, and we are praying for you. We're praying for your country, you're praying for your continent, and for your work there.
Thank you very much. And I send to you lots of greetings from our brothers and family in South Africa to you as well.
Thank you so much. And we bring you also, on behalf of the churches here in the Philippines, the Open Door supporters, those with me here now in the Facebook Live, thank you so much. And we bring you, we bless you with the Lord's protection in the midst of this epidemic. God bless you.
Talk to you soon.
God bye.
Thank you. Take care. Bye-bye.
Bye. Bye. Okay. Ayan po. Si Natasha from Open Doors South Africa. So kasamahan po namin siya sa South Africa that raises support and prayers for persecuted Christians doon po sa kanyang bansa. Thank you so much, Kuya June, for saying it is clear, and kay Ma'am Glenda for saying it's loud and clear. Thank you so much. Okay, and dyan din, joining us si Daddy Dimok, also from Italy. Hello po sa inyo, keep safe there. Si Ate Donna is also there, at saka si Ate Ella is also there. Okay, so we still have a few more minutes, and I'd like to share more about what is happening in the persecuted church sa continent po ng Africa, sa more countries na meron po tayong information on how they are coping up, on how, and especially the persecuted church facing COVID. Okay, sabi sa sa region po ng Sub-Saharan Africa, ito po yung mga bansa like Somalia, Eritrea, Nigeria, Central African Republic, Burkina Faso, nabanggit po ni Natasha kanina, Mali, Ethiopia, Kenya, Cameroon, and Niger. Ito po yung mga bansa in this part of Africa. At sabi po ng World Health Organization, sila ay nag-express ng concern sa pandemic specifically for this region because they have already overwhelming strained public health systems sa mga bansa po ito. No? So like some of the countries that we shared this week, no, they have strained public health system already. Sabi pa niya, a widespread outbreak in Africa will be a huge struggle because the health services are quite overstretched already, dealing with ongoing diseases like malaria and measles and the current Ebola outbreak. Now, ang similarity nito with the country previous countries that we have shared with you this past week ay yung kanilang public health system ay hindi rin maganda. Pero specifically for Africa, na meron na po silang dinideal na ganitong mga klaseng outbreak already in this region in Africa, no? So to add another something like that, to add a pandemic, no? Ano na mangyayari talaga sa kanila? With their very strained and poor public health system. Sabi ng aming director sa Africa for the ministry in Africa, sabi niya, we appeal to our supporters to not forget the persecuted church at this time. Aggressors don't wait for convenience and incidents continue to be reported throughout the region, particularly sa persecution. Sabi niya, please continue to pray for the Lord's protection over staff members as they minister to the persecuted church in the region amidst the current uncertainties. So he's asking us to pray for wisdom for all African governments as they get ready for an expected surge. No, they're foreseeing na with their health system ay tataas pa ang cases in the region. He's also asking for prayer for the church to be shining lights and beacons of hope in the midst of current uncertainties. And let's also pray for the Lord's wisdom and protection over the staff as they continue to work and reach out to the persecuted church even at this time. Some more reports from the countries. Sa bansa pong Madagascar, ito yung movie ng mga na cartoons sa mga animals. No? But Madagascar is an African country. It's an island sa southeast ng continent. And sa mga measures nila to help contain the virus and to protect their people is they have canceled all incoming flights. Okay? I'm not sure if Philippines has done the same, no? But I think that's a good move. Ang bansa pong Cameroon has closed all its borders. No, yung we also just like the Americas and Europe na nabanggit natin this week na medyo landlocked at lalo po ganun sa Africa at lalo pong mas marami ang mga bansa in between the whole continent, no, board napakarami mga borders in the African continent. And so Cameroon, one of the countries, has closed its borders. Ang bansa pong Ghana has implemented a mandatory 14 days of quarantine for all people arriving from abroad. Sa bansa naman pong Somalia, no, Somalia is an African country na number 3 sa World Watch list ng Open Doors, yung ating listahan ng top 50 most persecuted countries. At this year, number 3 ang Somalia in Africa. At ayon sa isang report from BBC, kahapon lamang, April 2, no? Ito po, very interesting. There is ito pong Al-Shabaab group na naka-link o naka-pledge ang allegiance sa Al-Qaeda. Okay? Sinasabi niya, they are warning Muslims to beware of infectious diseases such as the coronavirus. At sinasabi nila that viruses like this are spread by crusader forces. And when they say crusader forces, they mean Christians. So sinasabi nila, alam niyo itong mga virus na to, galing to sa mga Kristiyano. Kaya mag-iingat kayo. Sabi pa niya, these Christians have invaded the country and the disbelieving countries support them. No? So that's one threat and persecution that our brothers and sisters in Somalia are experiencing, no? Yun ang ipinapakalat na tingin about COVID na ito ay galing sa mga Kristiyano. At sa Somalia po, konti na nga lang po ang mga Christians, sabi dito, just a handful of them, and they have to practice their faith in absolute secrecy, no? Very secret lang because it can really endanger them. At sabi pa nila, the government is in constantly spying on them to look for signs of apostasy from Islam. Yung mga tumalikod from Islam or naging Christians from Islam, the Christians are being continually, constantly spied on. And The punishment is death. Pag nahuli sila, especially the converts, ay papatayin po sila. Very violent. And so, pero mabuti po na kahit po ganito yung mga sinispread na mga rumors ng isang grupo, especially this terrorist group, there are Muslim teachers. Pero po mga Muslim clerics na baliktad naman yung kanilang pinapakalat, very positive and encouraging messages that counter actually these lies, no? So salamat sa mga pagkakataong ganito that Muslims are helping Christians. Kasi marami din mga incidents that we that Christians there are also helping Muslim, no? Muslims. So salamat dahil on occasions like this ay ang mga Muslim neighbors nila ay kanilang naaasahan. Ano ang kinokombat na tamang mensahe ng mga Muslims na ito? So sabi nila dahil close na mga mosques, so yung mga ilan sa mga Muslim teachers and leaders ay instead na, alam niyo po sa mga mosques, no, merong mga loudspeaker, no, to signal them to pray, at minsan yung kanilang mga preaching ay doon nila pinaparinig. Pero dahil bawal lang mag-gather sa mosque, ilan sa mga Muslim leaders and the teachers ay nagtumayo doon sa mga areas na yon, sa mga crossroads daw, at sa mga gathering places, at yung iba rin ay naka-vehicle sa tumiikot-ikot na naka-loudspeaker naman. At ang sinasabi nila, they are not just encouraging people, the Muslims, to practice safety measures. Maghugas ng kamay, mag-practice ng social distancing. Pero sinasabi nila, they're emphasizing that Islam, their religion, encourages cleanliness even before prayer times. And also, sinasabi nila na ito pong sakit na to, itong pandemic na to, ay nandito na, o nangyayari na ang ganitong klaseng pandemic even daw nung panahon pa ni Prophet Muhammad. So sinasabi nila in a way, hindi po ito galing sa mga Kristiyano. No? These are already, something like this are already existing even before our prophet's time, no? Kaya salamat sa ganung klaseng effort to at least protect our brothers and sisters there. Yan po ay sa Somalia. Sa Nigeria naman po, number 12 in our World Watch list. Kahapon lang din po na news, ilan po sa mga communities in Nigeria, alam niyo po, ay nagpatuloy pa rin ang mga religious attacks in these communities. At nakakalungkot po yun kasi ito pong mga attackers na to ay talagang walang pinipiling oras o okasyon para umatake sila just to get rid of Christian communities. If you remember po si Naomi, she is from Nigeria who visited Manila and Iloilo noong 2018. Alam niyo po ba nung nandito siya, galing po siya ng Hong Kong and Taiwan, also for Open Doors Ministries. Alam niyo po ba nung nandito siya, ay yung kanyang hometown ay sinusugod din. Kaya meron pong isang gabi na hindi talaga siya makatulog at isang over breakfast time ako yung kasama niya na hindi siya makakain kasi paano ka naman makakain pero knowing that back home sinusugod ang village mo, no? So that incident is very real, is a very common incident, form of persecution sa mga bansa, sa bansa, sa mga communities in a country like Nigeria. And even in this pandemic ay nagpapatuloy yun. Now where are, especially daw dun sa gitna, sa central Nigeria, they call the middle belt of Nigeria. Now, despite the lockdowns and the curfews set by the government, ay nagpatuloy itong mga targeted attacks against Christians. Now, where are these communities and states in Nigeria na nakaranas ng attacks, especially amongst the, against the Christians? Noong Monday po, March 30, when we started this, no, nagkaroon ng attack sa isang community in Kaduna, in a place called Kaduna. They attacked two villages. At 10 Kristiyano ang pinatay. 10 Christians were killed. The motive for this attack is not clear, but Christians do believe it part to be part of the larger agenda to uproot Christianity in their area. At yung mga Fulani militants, ito yung mga a group of a particular Muslim group who frequently does these attacks, no? They also did attacked a Christian leader at yung kanyang kapatid, and they were killed on the same day. On the same day, just last Monday po. Noong Wednesday po, April 1, sa Plateau State, mga Fulani militants na naman also attack a community at around 1 a.m. daw, and 3 were killed. 2 men and 1 woman. No? At marami pa ang na-injured. At sabi ng report, many people now are homeless because their houses have been burnt by these attackers. No? Hindi na lamang sila nagpapapatay, at nagsusunog pa sila ng mga houses, particularly houses belonging to Christians. At sabi po, ito po ang nakakalungkot, isa sa tatlo, yung babaeng namatay, was 3 months pregnant. She was 3 months pregnant and now she was killed in the attack. And then 17 houses, along with food reserves and cars and motorcycles, were set ablaze. No, yung pagkain nyo as a community, wala na. Yung mga food reserves na yun. Sabi ng report, we believe that the latest attack on our people could have been prevented because when we noticed strange and suspicious movements pa lang daw the previous night, Tuesday night, the community made efforts to alert the security agents but nothing was done about it. So, around 10 p.m. daw, itong Fulani gunmen arrived in the community and started shooting and burning houses. An operation that lasted until 1 a.m. Wow, that's 3 hours of attack, of shooting. And people were injured and people were killed. At the same time na nangyayari po ito nitong Wednesday, you know, in another community, ay meron ding mga ganong nangyaring mga pag-atake. Sabi pa nung isang leader, no, itong dito sa unang community that we are talking about, sabi niya about 11:45 ay nagpatuloy yung pag-arrive ng mga attackers in their community at napakadami daw nila. They were so many that nobody could resist them. They burnt houses and other properties and killed people. Nung Tuesday, last Tuesday po, not this Tuesday, but last Tuesday, 2 more villages were attacked, 5 people were killed, and 2 were injured. And so they are calling us, sabi dito, we call the worldwide body of Christ to remember them in prayer. So let's pray for comfort sa mga kapamilya nila na naiwan, no? Mga naiwan nilang mga mahal sa buhay. Let's also pray that the believers in these regions, that the Lord will not allow any more further attacks on these on our brothers and sisters there on these villages. Let's pray for the Lord's protection for them. Now, last country that I will share with you for Africa and for this last for our live episode is the country of Burkina Faso, and nabanggit po siya kanina ni Natasha. It's number 28 in the World Watch List. At sabi niya, sabi sa report po dito, there have been high number of infections compared to most other countries in the region. Dito po sa Sub-Saharan Africa. Unfortunately, the response of the government is deemed slow. Schools are closed, universities are closed, at bawal din ang public gatherings, pero hindi daw malinaw if it is applying to religious gatherings. Pero authorities daw have banned gatherings na lalagpas sa 50 people, no? So dapat 50 people lang and below ang magagather. Now we need to understand that Burkina Faso is a poor country, it's an impoverished nation, and they have 20 million people. Kaya with this number of people and with the situation of their economy and for a pandemic like this para kanilang harapin, that is very that will be a very much struggle para po sa kanilang bansa. At hindi lang po yun, because just last year ay kakatapos lamang po ng almost like a civil war, at libo-libo ang namatay sa kanila, at sila ay just getting back in their feet to their feet from that violence last year. But eto na naman ang pandemic, no? So just imagine kung anong mangyayaring crisis on a long-term basis, on a long-term, yung para po sa bansang ito. Sabi niya dito ng news, yung kanilang health infrastructure was very much compromised because of the conflict and violence last year. And some 1.5 million people have cut or have lost their healthcare assistance dahil din sa violence. Nagsimula nung violence. And so sinasabi nung mga NGOs doon working for the people of Burkina Faso, so itong mix ng conflicts, at because of the war, ay marami nang pumunta sa iba't ibang lugar, they were displaced, and then their weak health infrastructure, no, so itong lahat na, tapos ito pong pandemic, no, all of these factors, sabi ng mga NGOs working there, ay this will really lead to a devastating loss of life. Marami po talaga ang mamamatay, sinasabi nila. Not just triggered by this pandemic, along on top of all of their experiences mula pa last year. At sinasabi pa niya, in a worst case scenario, this country would see fatality rates 5 to 10 times higher than the global average. Ito pang very interesting. Sa kabila ng ganito yung klaseng sitwasyon nila, alam niyo po, they only have, sabi niya as of this writing, 400 coronavirus test kits. For what? 20 million people? 400 lamang. And they only have 3 health facilities in the country to carry out these tests. Doon daw sa capital and one of the big cities in the country. Sabi nila, we need technical and financial partners to come in and protect Burkina Faso, as do other African countries which are facing the same situation. Okay, we have come to the end of our live session, especially as we speak about Africa. Sorry for ending with such negative news, pero it's a reality that is happening to persecuted Christians in these countries. At imbis na magbago sana, no? Imbis na mag-lighten yung kanilang kondisyon, and now that with the pandemic, ay again, double jeopardy sila, no? On top of restrictions, of discrimination, on top of everything else that caused them to suffer, and now this pandemic, no, that doubles their suffering, no? Kaya I'll end with a message of prayer. Patuloy po natin ipanalangin, alalahanin ang ating mga kapatid sa Panginoon na pinag-uusig, especially at a time like this, sa ating pong hinaharap na pandemic. No, so let's pray for the isolated believers who were already isolated before pandemic because they converted to Christianity from their major religion, and they were disowned by their families, and now they're living in isolation. So buti po nga sa atin, no, dito sa Pilipinas, at least dahil bukod sa wala po tayong ganito, tayong mga pamilya ay nagtutulungan. Pero imagine a person or persons na walang family support system because of the faith, because they were disowned by their families because of turning to Christ. No, let's pray for those kinds of believers, and ipanalangin niyo rin po ang gawain ng Open Doors in these countries as our teams there are planning, are strategizing, are thinking of creative ways to reach out, to give relief packs, to coordinate, and to strengthen the persecuted church at a time like this, no, yung kailangan po nila. So ipanalangin po natin ipanalangin po natin sila. Medyo na mental ba ako dun sa mga narinig natin sa Africa, no? But it really just calls us to intercede for our brothers and sisters in Christ. Okay, before I let you go and promote some things, if you will still stay after our promotion, tayo po'y manalangin. Let's pray. Father, we just thank you for the freedom that we have here in the Philippines, yung aming pong religious freedom sa aming constitution and implemented by our government officials. Lord, we have our own forms, our own levels of persecution, but Lord, we recognize and we are aware, especially now, that hindi po yun ganun kagrabe katulad po ng mga ibang dinaranas ng aming mga kapatid sa Panginoon na usig. Especially dito po sa Africa, that they are being persecuted violently, na kahit po sa gitna ng mga lockdown or quarantine or this pandemic, Lord, ay nagpatuloy ang pag-uusig sa kanila. And so, Lord, we pray for them. We pray for the families na namatayan because of persecution, because of attacks there in Nigeria, sa mga villages, sa mga communities that were attacked. And countries like Burkina Faso and Libya, Cameroon, Madagascar, Lord God, especially those who have poor health systems, especially those countries na meron ng already dealing with various diseases, various outbreaks, and dagdag pa itong pandemic na coronavirus. Lord, we pray that you save them. We pray that you bless them with health workers. Hindi namin alam, Lord, kung paano. Dahil hindi kami makagalaw, hindi makapagpadala ng tamang tulong because of lockdown, because of quarantine, because borders are closed, Lord God. And so we pray, Lord, that, but Lord, we trust you, Lord, that nothing is impossible with you. Na hindi man kami makakakilos, Lord, in our own limitations. Pero kayo, Lord, ay kayang-kaya niyo pong kumilos mightily sa buhay, sa mga pangangailangan ng aming mga kapatid sa Panginoon, especially in Africa. We also, Lord, pray for the plans of the persecutors, yung mga terrorist groups, yung mga extremist religious groups, Lord, even the governments, Lord God, that they will stop, they will, Lord, you will confuse their plans, how you have confused those who built the Tower of Babel, Panginoon. Create disunity among them para hindi po matuloy yung mga atake sa mga communities at sa mga buhay ng aming mga kapatid sa Panginoon doon. We pray, Lord, that governments will do all they can, Lord, that they will set aside corruption, they set aside selfishness, Lord God, and they will really fulfill their roles to minister to the people. Lord, bless these things, bless these reflections, bless these things that we have learned, hindi lang po sa aming mga narinig sa araw na ito, kundi sa lahat po ng mga tinuro ninyo po sa amin sa buong linggo dito po sa aming gawain sa Facebook Live. Lord, thank you because as the title suggests, Lord, we can trade all our sorrows to you for your joy, for the joy of the Lord. And yes, Lord, we say yes, Lord, Lord God. Lord, this is our prayer, and this we ask in Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you for staying. I'm just so thankful. This is the first time that we did this po, mga kapatid. And salamat for keeping watch with me. Thank you for listening. Hope that you were blessed. Hope that you were encouraged by the many courageous stories of persecuted Christians in many parts of the world sa kabila po ng pagharap nila sa COVID-19. And this is how they are dealing with it. This is how they're facing it, no? And may the lessons that we have, that the Lord has impressed on us, ay dala-dala po natin, maging inspiration po sa atin sa mga panahon na tayo po ay nawawala ng pag-asa, nalulungkot, dahil po sa nangyayari po sa ating mundo, hindi lang sa ating bansa, pero sa ating mundo. Andito po ang, andyan po ang persecuted Christians, no, to help strengthen our faith, especially at a time like this. Okay, so I'll take this opportunity para i-promote pa rin ang aming pong fundraising appeal. This is for North Korea and the top 10 countries in the world watch list. At ito po ay nasa aming website, www.opendoors.ph. Maraming salamat po. Meron pong mga nagbigay this week nung after the live sessions, nagbigay po sila. So maraming salamat po sa inyo. And for those that the Lord is calling to help persecuted Christians, you have heard how our ministry is being used by the Lord to minister to countries like this, no? Kahit po delikado, kaya, pero let's pray for them. And if the Lord is touching your heart to give, punta lang po kayo sa aming website, opendoors.ph. You can give via BDO, BPI, PayPal, GCash, or PayMaya. Andun po ang aming mga account details. And if you'd like to know the complete list ng top 50 countries ng World Watch List kung saan pinaka-delikado maging Kristiyano, nandun din po sa aming website ang mapa ng World Watch List. This is the World Watch List map. Okay? Hindi nga lang po kami makapag-send sa inyo ng printed, pero if you have printers at home, feel free to print after you download this PDF copy of the map, no? And display it sa inyong mga kwarto, sa inyong bahay, sa inyong mga churches kapag pwede na, para people will always see where persecuted Christians are from. And then, we also release a quarterly magazine, and this is our second quarter issue, and this features the top 10 dun po sa World Watch List. Now, so more information are here sa second quarter issue ng Open Doors Magazine. At hindi lang po mga kwento at news about the persecuted church, pero sa loob din po niya yung ating mga prayer calendars for persecuted Christians, kung saan every day there's a country, a pastor, a church to be prayed for. Ito po yung April, ito yung May, and ito yung June, no? And yan po ay you can also download in our website, opendoors.ph. Especially po sa mga prayer meetings nyo online, if you like to include the persecuted church, especially after hearing these things, isama nyo po yan. Use that to pray for persecuted Christians. And ito po naman, kung ito po yung top 10, ito naman po yung kompletong top 50 World Watch List prayer guide ng Open Doors. Wala po ito sa website, pero we can give you a copy. Just message us or contact us so we can email you a copy of this for free also. So ito po ay hindi na lamang top 10, pero the complete top 50 prayer guide of for World Watch List. So yan po, like Nigeria number 12, kanina we talked about it. Maldives at number 14. China 23, Vietnam 21, and so on and so forth. No, so if you want more information, and feel free to share this to your church members. No, download the PDF copy. Just send us a message or a direct message, or meron din po kaming contact details sa aming website, a mobile phone, an email, or even dito sa Facebook po. Please send us a message if you want us to send this material to you. Okay, since you are still there, babatiin ko lang po yung ilan sa mga humabol dito sa ating, na hindi ko po nabanggit lang kanina. Ma'am Flora Pili, sabi nyo, thank you for your blessings for Natasha. No, and also si Ma'am Diana, salamat po for your blessings also for Natasha. Si Ma'am Grace Bumanglag is there. Okay lang po if you came in late. From Quezon City po siya. Si Sir Raymundo Tumakder. Okay. Okay. Hindi ko masyado maintindihan yung kanyang sinabi. Okay. And then si Vairin from Baguio is there. Hello. Ma'am Lilian Tan is also there. Leonora Mata, God bless din po sa inyo. At LC is there. Si, thank you for joining us a prayer. Ma'am Glenda, she said amen. Ma'am Leia is there. God bless you too. Thank you, Ate Maro, for being blessed, sabi mo dyan. And thank you for your commitment to pray for the persecuted church. No? Ma'am Flores also there. Sabi niya, thank you. Nag-message siya, thank you so much. Till next time, God be with us, especially persecuted Christians. Praise God. Amen. And also, thank you, Kuya June, for joining us in prayer. Okay. Now, for our last singer, para po sa ating live session for today, as you have seen in the post, ay kakantahan po tayo ni Gail Dizon Acar. Siya po ay worship leader ng GCF Ortigas. GCF po is one of the big churches we have here in the Philippines. And schoolmate ko po siya sa high school, although higher batch po siya. And she is also a season 1 finalist sa Star in a Million. So doon po sa inyo na naabutan po ito. This is a singing contest in ABS-CBN kung saan po galing si Eric Santos at si Christian Bautista. So kabatch po niya yan doon sa season na yan sa ABS-CBN. So she will sing for us together with her mom and her husband. No, it's a family recorded song para po sa atin. So may we be blessed sa message ng kanta nila. Okay? Muli po, maraming salamat for joining me, for joining us sa buong linggo ng Trading My Sorrows, How Persecuted Christians Are Facing COVID-19. Ito pong Facebook Live special ng Open Doors Philippines na nangyari po this whole week. I pray that you will all be safe. Enjoy the weekend and even the Holy Week next week. Nawa po, you will also have meaningful celebrations of the Holy Week kahit po tayo ay nasa ECQ pa din. Maraming salamat po ulit sa inyo. Goodbye until the next Facebook Live special of Open Doors Philippines. God bless you all.